Okay, so I've managed to brick the controller on the Annette A8, and I've got myself a device to unbrick it. I'll just go to my eBay, show you what I bought. I bought two. So I think it's this one here. I bought this one, it wasn't particularly good. You see, it's a ASP programmer. Okay, what I'm going to do is flash the original bootware on this, and the way you do that is by going to the IDE that comes with the firmware. And the problem is this one here hasn't got the right settings in the board or the program. So I'm going to open up Skynet version 2.3.2. It's also this one here, which, so I've got Arduino 1.8.0. If I open this up, IDE, you can see in the board section it says Annette V1.0, which is the board that I'm using, and it's also set to USB ASP. Now what I can do with this plug the ASP in. You want to make sure that you put the 6-pin connector in the right way around, so make sure you look at the diagram and the images in the troubleshooting section of the firmware. Essentially you're going to follow these steps. Very simple, you just press burn bootloader. Open this up a bit. That's the script there. So the next thing you want to do is go to documentations, troubleshooting. I'm going to go to the firmware reset. I'm gonna open the AVR dudes. Change that to USB ASP. Set the port USB. The MCU is going to be changed to 80 mega 1.284p. I'm going to open the firmware with the auto level, press go, and that should write that hex file onto the. Okay, so I'm back to the factory reset. That's a bloody relief, and I can actually see some information now on the blue display panel. Before, all I had was two white lines. Okay, so that's how you unbrick the control board on the Annette A8. Okay, so I tried to update the firmware on the Annette A8 using the Arduino IDE that came in the folder with Skynet version 2.3.2, and I was getting some error messages. I copied them down, it's what it kind of looked like, and essentially this was the error message, or the attempts to kind of place the firmware onto the controller wasn't working for whatever reason. I don't know if unbricking the device did something with some of the settings. I'm not fluent enough with this to really identify. I made a lot of changes to the configuration files based on what I've read and watched, and I figured out a way of getting around that problem by using the ASP unbricking device that I bought, and this time actually creating a hex file. So you want to make sure that you put a configuration file into the folder containing the Skynet Arduino files. I modified one myself, and the gist of it is on screen now. Then what I did was create a hex file, and to do that you press export compiled binary, and it dumps that in the folder with the rest of the firmware information that you're sourcing from. So once that's done, I'll show you. So it's compiled a sketch. Essentially what you do when you're adjusting the configuration file is you make a change, you save it. I was working on Notepad++, and then you go into the Arduino IDE and you verify it and see if you get any error messages, and generally if you've missed a step or something is clashing, it will, so something will be flagged up with a message essentially. So once that's done, you go to your Skynet folder and you search for the hex file, HEX, and you can see two files have been created, one with a bootloader and one without. Now you go back to the documentation folder, you go to troubleshoot again, firmware reset the AVR dude plus stock firmware hex, and then you go to AVR dudes and you open the AVR dude, the application. You then change the USB ASP, which was the thing I showed you on screen that I bought from eBay. You change your port to USB, and then you change the MCU to the type of Arduino that's on the Annette A8, which is an 80Mega 1284P. And then you go to flash, and then you navigate to the Skynet folder, and I'm going to go with the one with the bootloader. Press OK, and then you press go. I noticed a few people had sort of asked questions about the same problem that I was having. No one seemed to answer them. And the reason I got into this mess in the first place was because I was trying to get a 3D touch probe to work on the Annette A8 using the Skynet firmware. I can honestly say the world of 3D printers is very different to CNC routers. It's very idiosyncratic and the software mirrors that. But the printer is back up and working, and the stock proximity sensor is also doing what it's meant to. I just need to decide what to do with the footage up to the moment I brick the Annette. I don't think I'm going to have another go at trying to install the 3D Touch probe. Anyway, thanks again for watching.